minutes away from welcoming the players onto court for the men's doubles final.
City has in common is when you walk outside, the show never stops. Auckland, the show never stops.
Well, it certainly felt like the show wouldn't stop, didn't it, in that last match in the women's doubles. It did eventually after an hour and 40 minutes, and it means we have one more offering for you on finals day at the New Zealand Open. Here we go.
Welcoming our umpire for the final match on finals day here at the Skycity New Zealand Badminton Open. Our umpire is Trish Gubb from New Zealand, and the service judge, David Turner of Australia. And the first finalists in the men's doubles final. From Indonesia, it is the seventh seeds, Fajar, Alfian, and Rian Ardianto. And they'll be up against the Chinese duo of Huang, Kaixiang, and Zheng.
Well, we started the day with teenagers on top, and it's the way it's going to end, because on court, two 19-year-olds from Indonesia and a 19 and an 18-year-old from China. There have been some teenage sensations, but let's not forget the 35-year-old Li Hyunil in the mix as well. So how do you follow that? And the difficulty as well here, Oliver, for these players is they've been waiting, and they've been waiting, thinking, here we go, four match points, we're coming up. No, we're not. Sit down. How do you deal with that?
It essentially just extends your warm-up. Basically, they would have been pretty ready to come on at the end of the second of that women's doubles, but that's badminton, that's how it goes, and they would have probably sat down for 10 minutes and chilled out for a little bit, and then maybe warmed up a little bit again towards the end of the third set. But you do have to chop and change your preparations to what goes on before you.
And I suppose if you're Zheng Siwei, well, good. I've been on court already today.
Yeah.
It's just give me a little extra rest time before I take on these two very fine Indonesian players. Our umpire here is Trish Gubb of New Zealand. It should be a good match, well, really should.
Let's make some noise.
I don't know if it'll be as dramatic as what we last saw, but
you're doing well to top that.
Yeah. This is a very good young men's doubles pair from China, the Asian junior champions. They've been world championship runners-up as well in the junior section, but they're up against the young Indonesian pair who just seem to be improving, 19 years of age, the pair of them, and they were very impressive yesterday against Lim and Hoon. But we're looking at the Chinese players here first. Zheng Siwei is already been on court today. There's Zheng Siwei, and well, already a winner today. And can he make it two wins out of two? Of course, he was on court beating Xie Huan earlier on today. She's eventually got her winner's medal for this New Zealand Open. And this is how they got there yesterday. Very, very impressive against Marcus Kido, the former Olympic champion. And his partner, you can see round one against another Indonesian pair, they were pushed all the way, but they've only played one event previously this year. That was in the Osaka International Challenge. They lost surprisingly in the first round. They've been playing seniors events, even though they're only 19, 18, for the last couple of years. They got to the final of the Indian Open Grand Prix gold last year. Lost to Li and Liu. But after the World Juniors, they've struggled a little bit at the senior events at the end of 2014. Had a bit of time apart, maybe to freshen them up a bit. And, well, you never know, this could be the one that really gets them going. Fajar, Alfian, alongside Mohammed, Rian, Ardianto here. As you can see, seeded number seven, pretty good win-loss ratio. This year they've won at the USM Leaning International, second win of the year, also won the Austrian Open. In between that, they lost in the first round at the German Open, the Osaka International and the Vietnam International, but they also won the Indonesian International Challenge last August. That was their first event together. So less than a year together, already three wins under their belt against the top Chinese pair, Asian junior champions, but yet haven't quite managed it at senior level. So it's going to be an interesting matchup.
Certainly, as we've seen the Indonesian boys get better and better throughout this week as the tournament's gone on, they've been tested from day one. So it's an enthralling encounter set for us.
Yeah, kind of feel the more pressure on the Chinese pair because the expectation was them to fly at this level, and they haven't quite.
Fajar Alfian, Mohammed Rian Ardianto, Indonesia. On my left, Zheng Siwei, Huang Kaixiang, China. Fajar Alfian to serve to Huang Kaixiang. Love all.
So the final of the day at the New Zealand Open, and it's China versus Indonesia. Four talented teenagers on court.
service over.
We were both impressed, weren't we, by Alfian and Ardianto yesterday?
Yeah, they certainly showed the mature side. Wouldn't suggest they were teenagers, but it was a polished performance from them against the Malaysians, Hu and Lim. Almost a collision there from the Chinese pair.
Nicely put away by Huang. Rallies have been short and sharp so far. Is that what we can expect to see for the rest of the match?
I think especially early on, like both, particularly Huang from the Chinese side, but both the Indonesian players are really skilled around the net. So if they get, as soon as they get half a chance, they'll take it.
Five.
Or is it used, I'm used to seeing such long rallies after the women's doubles. Lovely placement from Fajar Alfian in there.
It seems like the Indonesians have picked up exactly where they left off yesterday afternoon.
Yeah, there was a real confidence about their play there. I'm surprised to see them take seven of the opening 9 points here. Fine start by them.
Play! Service over. 3-7.
They haven't met each other as a four before, but three of them have been on court before. Ardianto played against the Chinese pair
before. Seven.
He was saying that he reckons the key to winning here is not to be rushed. So the Chinese pair are quick. They need to be very good defensively. And it helps when you can be good on the offense as well.
Service over.
Yeah, it's a real, real hallmark of the two Indonesian boys. They are so good around the net.
Service over. 5-8.
But yeah, certainly been a very fast, very furious start to this one.
Impressive, I have to say. It's early days, and there's nothing decisive about this match yet, but boy, haven't they settled well.
Service over. 6. 10.
Settling into a rhythm now, aren't they?
8.
Huang and Zheng hit.
10.
There's a different outlook.
9.
Very quickly, isn't there?
10.
Yeah, that one was well read by Zheng, and definitely been
service over.
A real
11,
battle
9
early
interval.
On here in this men's doubles final.
Yeah, good start to the match. Alfian and Ardianto 11-9 up right now.
Wipe the court. Twenty seconds.
You have to say, it's semi-finals yesterday.
Wait.
There wasn't really much drama.
Wait.
I mean, it was good badminton, don't get me wrong, but
wait.
Today's been a step up, hasn't it? It's been exciting all afternoon.
Yeah, it really has. And in every final we've seen, there's been some real
11-9
real quality that we've seen.
Play.
As he departed, the gap was exposed. I've seen that before, and sometimes the opposition, they can get distracted by seeing someone rush off court like that, but not in this case. You done that before?
I can't say I have, actually. But no, I've definitely seen it happen quite a few times. You better to take the chance, though, to try and win the rally with a broken racket. It's pretty difficult. Great defense.
Yeah, well left.
Service over. 12, 10.
Stumble there from Zheng as he tried to execute that smash.
Wow! 14.
Yeah, great control there from Alfian and Ardianto. Just keeping the shuttle below the height of the tape. On the other side. Not allowing the Chinese to hit down.
Well, 15, it's a 5-point lead. It's been funny the way this game's gone. I mean, Indonesia on top, and then China came back, and now they're pushing away again. I wonder whether Huang and Zheng could claw their way back into this opening game again. Shout even louder. It's a nice little run of points, isn't it, this? Five in a row to open up a 6-point lead. You can't get that back.
11, 16.
Dangled on the top of the net before falling over.
Service over 17-11. Yeah, great coverage again there from Ardianto.
18-11.
And of course, Indonesia's blessed with some wonderful men's doubles pairings. Looks like they've got another very good pair on their hands here.
Service over. 12-18.
I just feel like China at the moment, they're kind of, not talking about this pair, but just in general in the men's doubles, they're obviously looking for someone to try and following the footsteps, which is not easier. Fuhai Fang and Tsai Yun.
19.
Yeah, it seems like they've been trying to change up their combinations recently and find something that's going to be successful. Well, they've had, Fuhai Fang and Zheng Nan at the moment, and Tsai Yun has been playing with somebody, a different partner as well. And they just haven't, of course, Chai Biao, Hong Wei. All, 19. Don't get me, all fantastic pairs.
Listen, they're all the top 10 of the world, but they haven't, obviously when you have a pair like Fuhai Fang and Tsai Yun that won as many world titles and many titles as they did. Not easy to find someone else in that, that caliber, is it, that clicks so well. But when you've got a pair like these two, they're going to, win the Asian title. You have high hopes. But you want to see them winning these kind of 15, titles first, don't you, really?
19.
Yeah, of course, it's a big step up from the juniors to senior level, although you wouldn't pick it from this final.
Yeah.
Sixteen, nineteen.
Game points have arrived for Alfian and Ardianto here.
20. Game point 16. Oh. Game.
Well, there you go. Impressive,
first
isn't it?
Won by Fajar, Alfian,
Mohamed, Rian, Ardianto.
16.
They always were ahead in that game. And in the end, saw it through by 21 points to 16. I mean, we watched them yesterday in the semi-finals, but I am surprised still that they managed to win that game as comfortably as they did.
Yeah, it was a surprise against the experience of Hoon and Lim from Malaysia. I think we can see it this afternoon as well. They're so good in the front of the court. It's just so difficult to get the shuttle down against them, and they will not give away a lift unless they really, really have to. And then when they do, they're defensively so solid as well.
2 minutes, guys.
They've been, I guess, on the attacking side more often than not so far in this match, and that's why they took the first game 21-16.
We have to get you to slow down. Just full 2 minutes, we have to do it. Who will serve? Huang. Who will receive? Twenty seconds.
Well, it was always going to be difficult to follow the women's doubles match, but
second game. Love all.
There were signs from Zheng and Huang at various points in that opening game that they can do something maybe to hurt this Indonesian pair, but confidence just seems so high from Alfian and Ardianto right now. It seems hard to burst that bubble.
Yeah, he's here. That's just another example there, a piece of individual brilliance from Alfian.
Two.
To start the second and straight away, it's a 2-love lead.
And they've been together as a pair since last August. This is an attempt for the Indonesians to win a fourth title. First at Grand Prix gold level as well, which would just be another shot in the arm for them if they can achieve it. You just wonder, I mean, obviously I hadn't watched the club match where Lee Yongdae played with Alfian, and you know, he's talking about, well, he can be one of the great men's doubles players of all time. You're thinking, well, he's a teammate of yours in the club. You just, you know, how much of it do you really mean, or are you just saying it as a club teammate? But from what we've seen here, maybe Lee Yongdae does have a point.
Yeah, well, I mean, to dish out that sort of praise from a guy like him is probably not something he would say lightly either. It's just been really, really impressive from these two Indonesians all week.
And what a start to the second game. I mean, to...
Yeah, 5-love in the blink of an eye.
Yeah.
Make it six.
Six.
It's slipping away from Zheng and Huang pretty quickly here if they don't do something about it. Mark at least.
Service over. 1-6.
Still time to retrieve the situation.
Oops. 2.
Just a little indecisive
6.
There.
Yeah, did everything right to set that one up. Been played at quite a high pace this match, in between points as well. Another mistake,
3.
This time from Alfian.
6. Service over. 7-3. Service over. 4-7.
Instinctive skills from Jinxi Wei there.
7.
And they fought back well, haven't they?
Got away with that
6.
One. Jing.
7. Change.
Change of racket, so Huang was going to serve, but needed a little bit of a warm up, did Ardianto say that?
Just sense a little bit of a,
7.
I guess, lapse from the Indonesians in the last 3 or 4 points. They've had a couple of shots that.
Yeah, you guys came up 6 love up. You maybe take your eye off the target a little bit. And that's long as well.
What a turnaround from a 6 love lead to an 8-7 deficit. But credit to the Chinese for being able to turn it around that quick. They seem to be taking charge a bit more of the first 3 situation. And again.
9. 7.
Oh, been an extraordinary start to the second game.
Service over. 8.
One, nowhere near
9.
Doing what he was intending to do. Getting all a little scrappy, isn't it?
10. Service over. 9-10. Service over, 11-9, interval.
So, they're a game down, but Huang and Zheng have an interval lead, 11-9. You know, topsy-turvy kind of start to the second game.
So much of this game so far being decided in the first 3.
Yeah, because we've had a game and a half and it's only 23 minutes old.
Yeah, the rallies have been significantly shorter than the women's doubles previously, but just goes to show in the men's doubles with the power that these guys have. You get it slightly
20
wrong.
20 seconds.
Points all over.
Thank you. Service fault called.
Service fault called against Huang.
Service over. Shuttle's too high. Shuttle. 10.
Yeah, just the
11.
Contact point deemed too high there by the service judge. Of course, that needs to be below your bottom rib.
Service over.
The end is sharp from Zheng in the first 3.
10.
It'd be nice to see the Indonesians just open things up a little bit. Play the shuttle more to the sideline like that.
13-10. Oh.
sure what Huang was thinking of there.
So it's over.
It was all
11-13. Service over, 14-11.
Just looking at the Indonesian faces, you wouldn't really be able to tell they're a game up in this one, would you?
Well, they were a game up, and don't forget six love up as well. And things are now slipping away, aren't they, in this game?
15-11.
Out as well.
16-11. Oh. Service over. 12-16.
Get into some rallies, 16. Indonesians, you feel they are maybe going to be the superior pair, but haven't really seen many rallies, have we?
No, you're right. The Chinese have, like I said, really taken charge of the first three, but yeah, absolutely spot on when the rally does get underway and
14,
continue for longer than three or four
16.
Shots. The Indonesian boys are winning the majority.
Set of badminton. Oh, what is going on there? I mean, that's again.
Serves over. 15,
from Huang again as well.
17.
Not even close to going out. Oh, they're showing some good power, aren't they?
Serves over. 18-15.
Saw that from Zheng, didn't we, earlier on today in the mixed doubles. Hard to believe that was 5 hours ago.
Fair to say he's well rested.
Service over. 16-18. Service over. 19-16.
Well, it might go to three games, but I think it's fair to say this one might be an hour and 40 minutes.
20. Game point, 16. Yeah.
Four game points for the Chinese pair of Huang and Zheng. Down to three.
Service over. 17-20.
To have a third and decisive game in the men's doubles to decide our final champion. 17. at the New Zealand Open. Huang and Zheng taking the second game there by 21 points to 70.
So we're heading into our third and deciding game here in the men's doubles final, the last match of finals day here in Skycity, New Zealand. And there's a reason before we get into that, we have our prize cannon to fire one last t-shirt into the crowd. Gone deep.
So what was Ardianto's and Alfian's mistake there? I mean, to be 6-love up, to let a lead like that go, was it down to the opposition or something?
I think there was a little bit of both. I guess we've seen two very different sets. The Indonesians dominated the first one, minus a little 5-point run from the Chinese, but it all comes down to the first three. At 6-love, the Indonesian boys lapsed in their concentration a little bit and let the Chinese back in the game. And then they managed to ride off that and control the first three from there. But as soon as the Indonesian boys play a bigger court and make sure the return goes away from the Chinese rackets, then they do okay, as long as they come out at least 50-50 of the first three, then there'll be no problem. But if they keep losing the quick points, it's really hard to come out on top.
Well, here we go, the final set in the finals of the New Zealand Open. Is it a case of a first senior title
play
for Huang Kaixiang and Zheng Siwei?
Play. One, love.
They've made a good start.
Two, love.
I've got to say, the general pace of play today has been good, hasn't it, as well?
Yeah, there's been some terrific exchanges, especially around the net. And that was a perfect example.
One. Two.
But no one really wasting time trying to rub the opponents up the wrong way, you know.
Oh, sorry, that sort of pace. Yeah, you're absolutely right, actually. It's all been very, maybe amicable is a bit too much, but pleasant.
Yeah, just getting on with playing good badminton.
Yeah. Nekor just throwing Alfian off a little bit there.
Service over. 3-1.
Crowd have been great as well, haven't they, inside, you know, made a really good atmosphere out of things.
Yeah, there's been plenty of support for Indonesia, China as well.
5-1.
It's really made for a good atmosphere inside the event center this afternoon.
Be nice to have a New Zealand player playing in the finals today though, wouldn't it?
Tell me about it.
Ardianto not
six.
Able to put up, so now it's
one.
Huang and Zheng who have come out of the blocks fast. Alfian and Ardianto hope there might be a similar kind of turnaround to the one they suffered in the last game, but momentum certainly has swung the way of Huang Kaixiang and Zheng Siwei here.
Both sides really just
service over.
Fighting for the net to come forward and be in control
two,
of that.
6.
Oh.
Which would mean there's a bit of space in the rear court, but neither side seems to be willing to use it.
Oh no. Ardianto gives up a gift.
Service over. 7-2.
He was stretching for it there, wasn't he? Well left, that was out.
8-2.
Don't mind that though. I think from the Indonesians, it just gives the Chinese something to think about, and they can't just rush forward. And
yeah, that's more like it. Good flat exchange.
Service over.
And too much.
3-8.
Bim, bam, boom, and it's all over. It was a, I mean, men's doubles, when it's played at its best, can be best of the five disciplines to watch, really.
Service over.
Yeah, I just think there's a bit too much of the flat exchange
just
going, being directed down the middle here from the Indonesians. They had more success in the first game, but they're keeping it to the sidelines.
Today, the day the Asian Junior Champions of 2014 passed through at senior level. When they lost that opening game 21-16 and 6 love down in the second, it seemed unlikely, but yeah, looking good now.
Service over. 4-10.
Attack at all.
5-10.
Furious pace.
Towels only, guys. Towels only. Towels, put the drink down. Put the drink down. Towels only on court.
She's stricter than some of the teachers, I know. But I mean, it's quite right, because don't forget, you know, Zheng and Huang are only a point away from an interval here.
Yeah.
5-10.
Now you can have a drink.
Service over. 11-5. Interval. Change ends.
Well, what a day it's proving to be. Another terrific final. Very different in feel to the women's doubles, but we just saw one of the best rallies of the day, that's for sure. And that, well worth another look, isn't it? Sort of slow mo. Kind of doesn't do it justice, because it was the speed of the rally, wasn't it?
Yeah, just through here, 1, 2, 3.
so much movement going on.
Yeah,
it
seconds. Had to be so ready.
20 seconds. Time.
Reacting to what your partner's doing and where he's playing the shuttle and where you want to play the next one. Being neither side willing to play over their opponents.
11-5. Play. Service over. 6-11.
Well, we've seen 6-point deficits being erased in earlier matches.
Is going to be a point in the sand, a marking point in their senior careers here at Huang and Zheng. The fact they've only played one event previously this 2015 season, and they lost in the first round of that after winning the Asian junior title last year. It's a big week for them, and well, maybe they are going to come away with the title. Because you do question yourself, you know, you do so
13.
Well. Junior level, and obviously the Asian junior title is considered something by some even harder than the world junior title. That aside, then you come into the senior level and it hasn't quite happened for you. You know, just need something to spark you, and maybe this is the week.
Yeah, this could well be it. So often you see the top Chinese juniors, though, after a year or so in the senior ranks, they really climb up fast.
14-6.
Until the likes of Chen Long do it in the men's singles after he was world junior champion in 2007.
It's not a guarantee, is it, to,
no.
to success at the top level, but it shows there is some caliber there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, the Indian Grand Prix gold last year, they played Li and Liu, the Chinese pair that won the China Masters the other week, and they went to the deciding game in that as well. They ended up losing it 22-20. So they certainly don't want things to get tight, because I'm sure memories might start come flooding back.
14.
And it's fair to say at the moment it's not tight.
No. Now they're looking. Yeah, it's never nice to lose 22-20 in the third, but particularly in a final.
Service over. 15.
But with an 8-point lead.
7. Service over. 8-15.
Things are shaping up. Zheng Siwei is going to be the golden boy, isn't he, in this finals day of the New Zealand Open. He started by winning the mixed doubles and closing in on the men's doubles title now as well. Let's put that
service
one wide
over. 9-16.
Been a winning position, hadn't it? You have to say for Alfian and Ardianto here. But like the women's doubles pair before, They've shown a great determination, Huang and Zheng, to turn this match around. Lovely touch from Zheng.
Yeah, ever since they were in six love in the second set, it's just been all the Chinese boys.
Yeah, it's a huge 10-point lead now.
Beautifully disguised from Zheng there.
And it's match points.
20.
They've been waiting for this moment, haven't they? Huang Kaixiang and Zheng Siwei, the Asian junior champions, have a title now at senior level because they have just won the New Zealand Open.
Okay. Match won by Huang Kaixiang and
Zheng
Siwei.
16-21,
21-17, 21-9.
19 years of age, Huang and Zheng, respectively. And you have to say, in that final game, it was pretty emphatic. 21 points to 9 they took it. Alfian and Ardianto saw a big lead slip. But Huang and Zheng are your champions. Yeah, they shone through, didn't they, in the end?
Yeah, they really did. It was the Indonesian boys that got off to a fast start. And they were really dominating in the offensive situations, but the Chinese boys managed to turn around and start to control the first three, and when they did change, the Indonesians had nothing in response, and they really ran away with it in the third set.
Well, what a day it's been. It's been an excellent afternoon, and turns out to be evening as well, of badminton here at the North Shore Events Centre in Auckland. Started off with, started and ended with Zheng on the winning side, didn't it? But alongside Chen with that comfortable victory, and then a bit of a surprise with Saina Kawakami seeing off He Bing Zhao. Li Xunil, classy performance from the 35-year-old against Chao Bin, and then we saw those two three-setters that went China's way in the doubles.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the presentation for the last match on finals day here at the Skycity New Zealand Badminton Open. It is, of course, the men's doubles. Our chair umpire, Trish Gubb, and service judge, David Turner. And our people giving out the prizes, our presenters are Zali Saleh from Skycity, VIP executive host, and with them, Toon Ang, Skycity VIP. The runners-up in the men's doubles final from Indonesia, Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto. And the winners of the men's doubles, Huang Kaixiang and Zheng Siwei of China.
Our fifth and final champions of the day, Huang Kaixiang and Zheng Siwei. Yeah. Lovely moment, that winning feeling for the teenage Chinese pair. Lovely way to end the day's proceedings. Let's hear from our champion, shall we, there with Stephen.
Well, boys, congratulations on winning the final. Juan, I'll start with you first of all. What was the difference getting out of that second game and going on to win the final?
首先先非常恭喜你们，那想要问就是说，这个从第二局到第三局是你们改变了什么，让你们赢得了胜利？主要还是一个不放弃吧，然后有必胜的那个信念，然后做好每个球吧。I
just play every ball like nice, every hit nicely, and just go for it and think about winning.
Zheng, it's been a great week for you, mixed doubles finals and now the doubles finals. How satisfying is that?
就是这次你进了那个混双的决赛，也进了这个男双的决赛，那对你来说是感觉怎么样？非常好，因为我这也是第一次两项进入决赛，非常开心，进入决赛都能取得冠军。
He's very happy and it's the first time that he's going to the final for both mixed and the men's double, and so it's just very happy.
Yeah, well, finally, congratulations, gentlemen, a senior title to your name.
就是非常恭喜你们，然后就是拿到这个senior的冠军这样。Thank you.
Yeah,
not bad, is it? 18 years of age, two titles in a day. Three wins today for China, one for Japan, and one for Korea. It was really a thrilling afternoon's action at the North Shore Event Centre in Auckland. It's been a fun week. I hope you've enjoyed it as well. Terrific Grand Prix gold tournament at the New Zealand Open. But from all of us here, it's goodbye for now.
Final stages of this 2015 Skycity New Zealand Badminton Open, and some of the officials and the coaches get there. He's coming.